How are you doing? Today we're going to be making a jack-o'-lantern. For this tutorial you will need a chopping board, some knives, a craft knife, a pencil, tea lights, a homegrown turnip. Now I'd like you to cast your mind back to those carefree days of childhood. For some of us anyway, who remember the 1960s and the 70s when we never even heard of what a pumpkin was, you know? And we used to make jack-o'-lantern heads out of turnips, homegrown turnips and sweets. And that was a tradition that's been going on for hundreds of years, literally. So the first thing we need to do is to prepare the turnip to carve. What I forgot to mention in the introduction was we also need a bowl and we also need a spoon. Okay? Okay, found a little snail on there, so he can go. So this is a homegrown turnip, straight from the plot, Golden Ball, which is a whole heritage variety, and you can understand why they're called Golden Ball. The first thing we need to do is we need to top and tail it. Some of you may want to make a lid on it, but as you can see, I've cut it at an angle, which I wasn't meant to do, but so be it. So I'm going to make this one without the lid, and what we're going to do, I'm going to straighten this off a bit here. So where is it? There we are. That makes it a bit straighter. So you can make it open here, or you can put a lid on it. I mean, it's actually better if it is open because it allows more oxygen to come through. If you're putting a tea light in, you put a lid on it and it can snuff out the flame because there's not enough oxygen getting into the, because they're quite they're not as big as pumpkins, obviously, so they don't, you know, if you've got a tea light in there and you put a lid on it, the candle flame can use up the oxygen pretty quickly. So I've used a big knife for topping and tailing. So now what I need to do is I need to scoop out all this middle bit. So how I do this is I'll use this knife for a smaller knife for getting rid of that. Basically, I'll show you how to do that. And then I need a spoon to scoop it out as well. So the first thing we need to do is we need to basically go around the turnip, sort of like scoring around. Like that. And then we need to go across and cross and then like this. So we're actually dividing it up into like little cubes. And then what we'll do is we'll cut them out And these put into a bowl. Okay, when we get to this stage, we just carry on scraping out with the back of with the spoon. Being careful not to thin the walls too much, but get enough out so that it's nice and smooth. I think that's about it now. That'll go into mashed potato. So that's lovely. And that's our pumpkin. Pumpkin? that's our turnip. That's our turnip done. Okay, without a lid. Because I don't think the lid will fit on that. No, it won't. Okay, this is where a pencil and a craft knife come in useful. So you can be as creative as you want with doing this. Also, I wouldn't recommend it for very young kids because you're using knives, unless you're in a very knife orientated family, which some people are. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna draw a face, just gonna make it up as I go along. So I suppose the simplest face is the one we all know. These are simple things to cut out. And possibly maybe a smiley face. Who knows? There we go. Okay. I'll just cut these out.
Now I'm mean and evil. Don't you mess around with me. Yes, I'm mean and evil.
And that's it. Mr. Turnip Head. To ward off evil spirits. And in true Blue Peter style, here's one with a lid that I did previously. Unusual. It's always nice to look for unusual shaped turnips with two sprouty bits coming out the top. So all we need to do now is to wait for nightfall and light them up. And happy Halloween to everyone. Hope you have a great time. And if you've enjoyed this video, please subscribe and like it if you like. And keep the evil spirits at bay. Bye-bye.